you go around the central sulcus, which is this line going down there, so just in front of the central sulcus will be the motor cortex, the primary motor cortex, the premotor cortex, which has been defined as such because if you stimulate electrically these regions, it's possible to evoke movements in a patient or in an animal. My name is Claudia Vargas. I am a professor at the Federal University of Rio de Janeiro. I've been working in the domain of motor control and plasticity after peripheral lesions in the brain. We focus on the model of brachial avulsion.
Meu nome é Ramírez da Mota Silva, tenho 17 anos. Há 2 anos eu sofri um acidente de moto, tive uma lesão no plexo. Há 1 ano eu venho me tratando na fisioterapia e me sinto muito melhor do que eu estava. Eu não mexia nada e agora eu mexo uns 80% e 70% do meu braço.
So, plasticity is a very general term which was introduced, reintroduced in the 80s. To speak about the capacity that our brains have to remodel themselves, to reorganize. You have a collection of possibilities in motor terms and sensory motor terms that you allow you to perform your movements in a very beautiful and optimized way. If you have a lesion, if you give the opportunity for the system to rewire itself peripherally, then your brain will have to take this new context to produce a new set of movements. Whenever you prepare to grasp an object, you have this brain activity that precedes the beginning of movement. Whenever I see a person performing that movement, you have a similar brain activity. So imagine, for instance, that you are the goalkeeper, you are just in front of the football player and trying to figure out where the ball is coming to hit you. This is something that we call predictions. I have an aesthetic relationship with nature in general. I think that this is where started my interest in science.
Costumbre de todo el mundo con la música. Como lo hace el fútbol.